Hello everybody, it's Guy Sebastian here. I'm doing something a little bit different today. I'm gonna do a piano tutorial. I'm gonna teach you how to play my new song, Standing With You. It's a very special song to me. And I'm gonna break it down. The good news is it's in C. So very simple in the key of C major. Let's get started. I think I'll start with the intro first. I'm gonna show you a couple of different ways to play this because some of you will wanna sing along. And when I play and sing, I will simplify stuff because I don't want the rhythms of what I'm playing on piano to get in the way with how I deliver a vocal. And some people are much more accomplished than me. I've self-taught on piano. I'm like a lot of you guys, I've jumped onto YouTube or Insta or whatever and learned how to play stuff just by ear. So let's get stuck in. All right, let's start with the intro chords, which is the same as the verse chords. So it does the same thing all the way up to the chorus. Now it's very simple. It starts with C, then D minor, then A minor, then F. And you'll notice the rhythm of it is C for this amount of time. One, two, three, four, 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 one, two, three, four. So it pushes that little passing chord. So when we say passing chord, it's basically that D minor is going to get us to the A minor. So C, D minor, A minor. Land on that for a while, then F gets us back to the C. There's a constant tension with these chords and they sort of pass into each other and it does this kind of tense loop. Now, this is the arpeggiated version of the intro, which is a little more difficult, but it's good. If you practice it, it sounds so cool. Here we go. So it sounds complicated, but it's actually quite easy. If you have a look at the shape of the chords, I like to play it like this. So I'm playing my octaves in my thumb and my pinky, and in between I'm playing that C. So that's a C major starting at the root of C, but I'm putting that G in there as well to give it that octave. So that's what you do for the first one. And in the bass, you're just going. So to slow it down. So then we move on to the next chord, which is the D minor. And for the passing chord of D minor, you've got to hit the bass note first and then the chord in your right hand. So it's like this. And then you're on to the A minor, but it's gonna sound like this. So let's do the C first. Then on to the A minor. Then the F does what you did basically with the D minor in this inversion. So if we just look at the right hand, we're basically going. So it's quite simple. And then once you add this bass note in, so if you want to, you can do that while singing the verse. Now, if I was doing it live, I wouldn't play that arpeggiated rhythm while I'm singing because A, I'm not really good enough to do it. So literally, you can just do this, like, the more I tell you, you can do this, the more you tell yourself you're useless, and the advice right now is fruitless,
You're somewhere only you can go. I won't pretend to know. So
just simplify it. I mean, if you can do the whole thing, the more you turn. If you can do that, awesome. But frankly, I think it kind of gets in the way of the verse if it's too pronounced. So you could even just do this. That's still beautiful. And you can sing over the top of that and not have to think about it. Now the chorus, you can start it in the exact same position. So it comes down to the C. But the second chord comes down. Now technically it's like a G6 over B. What does that mean? I mean, as a shape, it's like an E minor over a B bass note. But basically I'm playing the G chord, but I don't like hitting the D. I'll show you why. Listen to how happy it sounds when you hit that D in the G chord. So, I'm standing with you tonight, or I will be the pill for your pain. Oh, it's just so happy. There's no tension in that. But listen to the difference. Instead of hitting that, if you stay on that E, so, oh, I will be the pill for your pain. Just sounds so much more emotional to me. So that's the only thing I'll be a stickler about. Try not to hit that D, or if you do, add the 6, which is the E. And the bass note goes down to the B. So it starts off C, down to the B. Now, all I do when I play it is I literally just move all the bass notes down one, and I move this one finger, this index finger down to here. So it goes like this. Super simple. And then it gets us to the A minor. So all I'm doing is going from here, I'm just moving these two up. And then coming up here with my pinky. So there's not a lot of movement in your fingers in your right hand. You can pretty much hover around this space. See how simple this is.
Oh, I will be the goofy boy.
And you play that however you have learnt to play chords. This isn't a technical video of how to place your fingers. I play differently to everyone else who is self-taught. Should we get to the bridge? Let's get to the bridge. I love a bridge, and I love, especially in a ballad, when a bridge changes chords and changes direction and emotion, because the purpose of it is you're telling a story and the bridge brings that story home. So in this song in particular, there is a bit of a chord change. The end of the second chorus, we end on F.
I'm standing with you down to G. I know I may not say the right thing,
which is A minor, straight to the C, down to the F. So they're quite quick chord changes. So let's go through that, the front bit of the bridge again. So
I know I may not say the
A minor, C, F. So if we're counting, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And so that A minor and that C is kind of like a quick bridge to get to that F. So,
I know I may not say the right thing, let me tell you one thing, yeah, cause there is one thing you're wrong about.
And I love this change, it goes to the D minor.
This world will not be a better place. I don't want to lose you now, cause I'm standing with you tonight.
So, that second half, D minor, C, A minor, G. So that's almost it's almost like the opposite of the first half, but we're starting on D minor.
This world will not be a
C, A minor, G.
Cause I'm standing with you.
And then we do basically the same thing as the chorus, but you can do it up here.
Oh, I will be the voice in your ear, quietly destroying your fear. Oh, you won't even know that I'm here.
So you can do whatever you like, or you can just hit that F. However you build, you can figure that out yourself and give it your own flavor. I mean, you can do a little run up. So that's it. And then you go into the chorus, and I mean, you can play that a little bit more aggressively and emotionally.
Oh, I'll be the voice in your ear.
Give it all that you've got in that last chorus, and that's the song. It's quite simple. And there's a chord chart that I've included in the description below, so check that out as well, and have fun. You can change keys as well and transpose to the key that suits your voice. But I think it's nice doing it in C. It's very simple. Thank you so much. That's my first ever piano tutorial. Never thought I'd be doing one.